Hey guys, I'm Josh Oakes. I want to walk you through our content. The first 25 minutes of my speeches to parents are the student speech. Not only do I show the students this speech, but I give it straight up to parents. The first thing I go, let me show you what I showed your students. And I move quickly through it. We're going to look at that here in a sec. The next 25 minutes that I'm going to breeze through quickly are dialogue plus safety tips that you can use with your kids. And then the last part are the good and bad apps. We're going to breeze through this quickly, and then we're going to learn how to monitor your kids with our tool. So basically, how to shine online. If you have younger students, I ask them four questions. Is it okay to share my password with my best friend? And I ask this question in a way that where I have them raise their hand and say, how many of you have a younger sibling? And I get them pretending as though they're going to ask this to the younger sibling, which gets them to think. Question two, is it okay for me to talk with people online who my parents don't know? Question three, if I see bullying online and I click like or heart on that post, does that mean that I'm bullying also? Question four, if I see something bad online, who should I tell? My parents, my teacher, the principal, or Buddy the Elf? Put a lot of humor in this, so these kids giggle at that. We're going to look at a lot of student things. Okay, so how to shine online. We talked to students about the four things we're going to teach them. Search for yourself on Google. I'm going to teach you how to post in a positive way on Instagram. We're going to search for some celebs, how to lose an opportunity. I give them my background. I learned at Walt Disney Studios how the smartest marketers market products, and I walk them through how I took that technique and not only did they teach me how to market products, but how to build a great product, how to market it, and then I ran for city council. I was the youngest person on the ballot in Hermosa Beach, California. Here's me voting for myself on the day of the election. There's one thing I knew that I could do that none of the other candidates could do. I knew that people, when they would see my name on a sign or a bicycle or anywhere around the city, that they were going to search for me online, and that became my new resume. And the same is true for kids. Colleges are going to see this great application and they're going to go search for them, right? And I walk through this fun story and I lost by 350 votes. I got really close to winning and the incumbent mayor beat me. Everybody knew who he was. He was awesome. He's a good friend of mine now, but the incumbent mayor was well known and I wasn't, and I got invited to go all over the country to teach brands how to shine online using social media. Now, I teach your students how colleges will search for them online. This is a positive speech. How many of you have searched for yourself online? Most of the room raises their hand. Colleges are going to search for you this way, and I walk students through the ways. I'm going to breeze through this. And then we search for me briefly. Cool. And we look at my Twitter handle, how it's on the front page of Twitter. Whoa, crazy. And then we get old school, and we go search for me and look at my images. And I walk them through a story that's really neat on how we might have been able to save lives with a check that an organization made. And then we walk through all these little things, and we go, wait. Why is there a story, that weird picture of a baby dressed as Harry Potter? Oh, Josh, you don't understand. They're going to click on the most noble photo over here. Kids, do you really think that's how adults think? No, they're probably, you're right. They're just going to look at just that. And we laugh together and stuff. What's the weirdest image on your stuff? I walk through all these stories. Do you feel comfortable providing your usernames to colleges if they don't have time to Google? Let's put your best foot forward and have nothing to hide. And I walk them through a story here. And then Instagram posting ideas. So we searched for your kids. Now we're going to talk about, in a positive way, creating a portfolio of positive images. Here's my formula. Volunteer somewhere. I walk the kids through. While you're volunteering, take a classy group photo. Say thank you to the organization or thank you to my friends for joining me in this activity. Here's what this looks like. We walk through a few of my friends that are successful. Thanks to my friends for letting them do this. Thank you to Shelter Hope Pet Shop for letting us share some of this. Far right is Lisa. Special thanks to my team at Disneyland for all that they do. Far left is Kelsey, Miss Utah. Thank you to my friends who supported me over the last year letting me do this, right? Now, let's go search for some celebrities. A lot of adults say, what does your online brand say about you? But colleges are really wanting to know, can you be yourself and then when you're on their campus, be yourself, but keep it positive and full of gratitude. And that's what they're looking for in people that attend those schools. So we're going to search for Ellen Elf. If your kids are a Star Wars fan, and they usually go screaming at this, Finn, the celebrity, obviously one of the lead characters in Star Wars, and Stranger Things, we're going to search for Eleven. Stranger Things is on Netflix, if you don't know, and it is has a bit of a following, and students freak out about Star Wars, Stranger Things. They love Ellen, and Elf is just funny. And we're going to see if these people get into their dream school. Now, first, Ellen, we take a look at Ellen and we go, whoa, her Twitter handle is up there and you can rifle through her tweets. Whoa. And eventually, students, it's going to be Snapchat and Instagram and Twitter and all this other stuff. Let's go look at her images. We walk through her images. She's smiling. Awesome. Great. Great. But who's that? Oh, that's her friend, Kanye. So we walk through her images. We tell a story. Buddy the Elf, We walk through his images. Why is he doing the splits? We walk through his images. Why are these here? We tell a funny story. Next, we have Finn, who's awesome. And we walk through his images. And, oh, look, all these other buttons pop up here that are distracting people. We walk through his images. Why is that there? It's funny. The kids laugh. Why are his arms sticking out of a character? And then Eleven, we walk through her images, which is a really big show right now. If you haven't seen it, it's pretty cool. We walk through her. Why is that there? They laugh like crazy. It just gives them a story. You got to put a lot of humor in this. She's telling a story, and then there's Justin Bieber getting arrested, right? And they laugh like crazy. Why is Justin Bieber ruining her Google results? What if I don't like my Google results? We show them how to volunteer their photo at events and then decide text the ones that they don't like to their friends privately so that their friends can have them, but then the one that looks the best, where I look amazing in the middle, that's the one we post online. How to get fired with one post. We teach them Cisco's a huge company, fun place to meet new friends, different countries, powers 300 million households. This young woman, she applied and she got the job. I'm breezing through this, guys. And then she tweets this. Cisco offered me the job. Now I have to weigh the fat paycheck against the daily commute and hating the work. And the students go, oh. Now they did see it, and this was a generous opportunity. There's a whole story behind it. Somebody else tweets, who's the hiring manager? I'm sure they would love to know that you will hate the work. We here at Cisco are versed in the web. Do you think she got this job? No. If you Googled her now, students, the whole story, now it was picked up by all these people. Now her Google results are cluttered with all of these people that wrote about her. But the world's not easy. Here's the three words that I use to keep myself safe. Before I respond, I go, is this light? Is it positive? Is it fun? Is it bright? Be smart. Think first. And is it polite? Are you proud of it ending up on a billboard for everyone to see? If it is light, bright, and polite. I tell students, search for yourself on Google. Decide if you're happy with those results. Look at your Instagram as a portfolio. And then sign up for LinkedIn and YouTube when your parents are ready for you. I'm Josh Oakes, thanks. So that's our student presentation. You just saw our 25-minute student presentation in about 8 minutes or whatever that was, just guessing. Okay, we show that to parents. You're basically seeing the parent version of it. I walk students through it, and then we're gonna go into section two. End of student presentation, start a parent presentation, right? But we show the parents the student presentation. Parents get the same intro. Ran for politics, Walt Disney Studios background, learned from the smartest marketers, knew that my Google results were important. I've written 6 books on this topic. Each of my books teach people and businesses how to shine online, but I also want your kids to get a job here. Many of the companies that we've worked with back this type of shine online, hardworking, good Google results version of things. All right, so we showed you the student, that we're gonna talk about dialogue and safety and then good and bad apps, and we're gonna talk a little bit about Parent University at the end. Discussion topics, should my kids be public or private? We talk through all the discussion topics. You can pause this and read those. I've got a 3-step plan. 1, Google your kids. I walk people through that. 2, dialogue with your kids. 3, post positive content online when you're ready for your kids to be online to improve their online image. Very positive. But Google first, every family. Now, Google first if your kids are not online. Google first if your kids are online. Why would you do that? Well, if I didn't push positive content out there, you wouldn't find all these good images of me. Instead, you would see images of these people that got arrested. Because these are on my Google results. They're not me. They're not people I know. But they would be, this is how every student is. There's somebody that got arrested in their Google results. So if you don't create positive results, these come up first. They confuse people. Dialogue with your students. Visit a college campus. Get your students excited about their future. Post positive content. Work with your kids. Post volunteer photos. We dive in deep as to what this looks like. I use myself as an example. Okay, so Google your kids. Dialogue. Post positive content. When should my kid be public? Well, parents decide when. Our suggestions are 0 to 13 private, 14 to 15 family discussion. 15 is when you start. 17 is when all of a sudden your kid has a positive online image. We walk people through this. Sorry that I'm moving quick, but I want to breeze through this quickly. A lot of parents look at the red zone only and they work against their kids what not to do, but we look at the green zone, have a dialogue about what goes wrong, talk about the future, use Instagram to get there. Key takeaway number 1, the best safety resource is not a social media app, a tool that tracks your students, keeping your students away from everything electronic, ignoring the internet. Instead, the best safety resource is having a dialogue with your kids. We walk them through, how many of you are on Facebook? Parents raise their hand. How many of your kids on Facebook? Almost 0 hands raised. Do you know why? Well, because they don't want to be where you're at, consider using your next social media friendship with your student as a resource to help with the dialogue. What do you mean? Consider not commenting directly on your student's posts and telling them how much you love them. Oh, honey, I love you so much. Parents are laughing usually at this moment. Instead, use your kids' posts passively to start a discussion in real life around the dinner table or the car ride home from school. Make your kids the expert and have them teach you how to use the apps in the green zone or the gray zone. While you're learning from your student, try not to say, why would I ever want to retweet something? It seems ridiculous. In my day, it snowed. It was uphill both ways on a horse, and it was snowing every day. You know, instead, okay, what happens when I do that? Show me more. I'm open to this idea. This opens up a dialogue, shows your students you're approachable in the future to talk about social media issues, because that's our dream, is that the parents get approached first and parents can help the kids. Key takeaway 4, what's the best time to give your kids a phone? I introduced them to waituntil8th.org. It's an awesome website that walks you through how to empower parents to say yes to waiting for a smartphone. Why wait? Take action. And it basically says wait until 14 years old, which is, I think, is so good. It gives kids a little bit more of their childhood. Concerns. We walk through concerns that parents bring up to me all the time, and we walk through them. Super important. We walk through the green zone, the gray zone, and the red zone. What? You can go look at this on our site. You probably already know about this. The green zone's good for these 4 reasons. The green zone, we read all this, and then we walk them through apps that are the lesser of the 3 evils, right? You can go look at this on our site, but we walk them through all this stuff. We even have some videos if people have a lot of questions. I walk them through detailed guides. Then we walk them through the gray zone. And this is where parents must participate with their kid. This is where Snapchat lives. Also, Facebook Messenger for kids. I don't think this is so good for younger kids. Minecraft, Musical.ly, TBH, WhatsApp Messenger. Remember, I'm breezing through. You can watch, you know, how does Snapchat market to your kids? We walk people through how Snapchat markets. And it's pretty funny. It dialogues and they go, oh, I get why kids are on it. Snapchat'll, and then with the truth behind it. Okay. And then we go in the red zone. And the red zone is after school, Ask FM, Blue Whale Challenge, Burn Book, Calculator, Finstagram, Look App, Kick Messenger. These are all the apps where predators are at, where it's anonymous, it's just really bad stuff. Saraha, Street Chat, Tide Pod Challenge, WeChat, Whisper, Yubo. And we basically have the top 15 apps that are at that moment the hottest, the ones that are dead and stuff. We leave them on the site, but we don't show them to your parents because we don't need to waste their time. That's the end of the red zone apps. Now I'm going to teach you how to find out if your student has a spam account, a Finstagram account that you might not know about. We teach them exactly how to do this. We point to the buttons that they have to do and how they find it. And parents love this. How can I monitor my kids online? We teach them exactly what we taught them the second time. So here's how you do this. We have a tool that you can use. It's called Footprint Friday. And we let people get 14 days, 7 to 14 days for free to try it out. And we walk people through the tool and why it's so powerful. Remember, my goal is to be positive and to show parents that there is a plan for them. They have to build good Google results and move in this direction rather than scaring them. I don't scare them. I just show them, these are the bad apps, but here's the good apps. Let's do this, 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 and this. And then we show them how it sends them a weekly tool and all this different stuff, what real moms say about this. And we give them a free 7-day subscription at the end of it. They can sign up for our newsletter and all that stuff. We show them how to sign up for Footprint Friday. Start monitoring your kids online. This is where the only people in the country that seem to have a tool and be speakers, and we do all this stuff. We teach how the tool works. Pretty cool. But then we also walk them through our Parent University program. If they want to get free copies of all of my books, they can get access to how to set up all of these guides at the end and so on. You can learn more about that. It's pretty cool, and what parents say and all that stuff. And basically, that's how to shine online. But we also call it how to use social media to impress colleges and future employers. Okay, there's our content. I'm so thankful that you watched this. Watch the other video for our pricing, but at least you get an idea of how we talk to parents. At the end, they often come up to me and say, this was awesome. Thank you. You've helped my daughter do this or helped me do this. If a student is in this presentation, it's okay too. Usually the parent night is only for parents, but you get the idea. Okay, guys, thanks so much. Have a great day. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye.